The Veeam agents are a very powerful way to back up physical systems, such as a server, workstation, or even clusters, as well as workloads on different hypervisors. But on scale, you might want to manage them a certain way. Since the very first agent was released in 2014 to where we are now, centralized management has come a long way. Let's jump in the lab and take a look at a quick demo. So what we're looking at is the inventory section of Veeam Backup and Replication, which is part of the Veeam Data Platform. In here, I have a number of different protection groups made. Some of you have seen the other videos where we made some Windows and Linux ones. Let me tell you now a little bit more about the protection groups, policies, as well as your ability to drive restores. So let's go ahead and create a protection group. Now, the protection group is the organizational construct, and there's a lot of different ways that you can deploy the agent. It can be a list of individual computers, such as what I did for the Linux systems. Or it can go from a list of Active Directory objects, such as an organizational unit, which I did for the Windows agent. You can also load a list of files, pick up pre-installed agents, or protect workloads in the cloud. So many ways to protect physical workloads, workloads in the public cloud, as well as unmanaged agents pooled in under Veeam. Now, in the Windows example, which is where you'll see a lot of organizations have workloads, you can get some really good information right here. You can see I have 7, and by the way, when I did the video, I only had 6. Another one came into the mix, and it was automatically protected, and you can see that the last backup was less than a day ago. What's really cool is I can go into some of the details here. I can get information about the name, the IP, the version of the Veeam agent, if the driver's installed, as well as application plugins. I also can take a look at those plugins and install them, or even remove them from the configuration by uninstalling the agent if I want to maybe decommission a server or take it out of management by Veeam. I have that control right here. And much like other Veeam backups, I can do a quick backup, which is an ad hoc incremental backup where I don't have to have all 7 do their backups at once. Pretty cool stuff. And if you forget to do the recovery media, you can do that here centrally as well. That's a very important part of bare metal recovery, so keep that in mind. On the Linux agents, you might remember I deployed these too. I can also do the quick backup of those Linux systems of just that one, and similar controls. I can see what operating system, what version of the Veeam agent is in use, as well as if any application plugins are in the mix. And if I wanted to, I can right click and uninstall the agent or even deploy some of those enterprise application plugins. So a really similar set of controls across the different agents. And then I also have visibility to some unmanaged agents. So this is that very first video where I did that installation of Veeam Agent by itself. If I wanted to, I could roll it into a protection group or even take a look at the details of what version is running. So all in all, you have a lot of information about the Veeam agents inside of the central management. So just like that, it's really easy to do centralized management of the Veeam agents within Veeam Data Platform. Speaking of which, go on over to veeam.com and you can download a trial of the Veeam Data Platform today.